Hey everyone, Daniel here from Twin Bytes with another quick tech-torial for you. This time I'm going to be explaining to you how to shut down your computer if it is completely frozen on you. So we'll be able to fix the issue at hand as well as addressing any potential ongoing future issues. So I'm going to be going through them in order of the least damaging first. So the first thing to check is move your mouse around on the screen, or at least try to. Does the mouse move on your screen? If it doesn't, then possibly it's got a problem with the USB cable if it's a USB mouse. You can just take the USB cable out of the computer and then plug it right back in again, and the mouse may start working again. If it's a cordless mouse, then it could be either just turned off or you need to replace the battery on it. If the mouse does move around but you can't seem to click on anything or it won't respond to any clicks, then it could be that just some application is frozen or the operating system is frozen in general. And that takes us on to our next step of checking the keyboard. The first thing you can do is just hit the Windows key on the keyboard and that should bring up your start menu. It may take a few seconds, so give it a chance because the computer is already frozen and backed up probably with a bunch of resources. So after 5 to 10 seconds of pressing the Windows key on the keyboard, if the start menu still doesn't come up, then what you can do is try pressing Control, Alt, and Delete by holding down the Control and Alt and tapping the Delete key. Once you do that, it brings up the task manager. You'll see a list of all the tasks in here, and from there you may see one that says not responding. So you would just highlight that one, assuming your mouse works, and then you can click End Task. If the mouse doesn't work, but you can get in here with the keyboard, then you can navigate using the keyboard arrows and then using the Tab key to go down to the End Task button. Maybe it seems like it's not responding, but really it's more that the computer slowed down on you or you're just too fast for it now. I've seen many times where it's just the end user is going way too fast for the computer and the computer can't keep up. And you can't ask a person to slow down. So if they're that fast, we call them power users, they need faster computers. So it may be time to upgrade the computer or just do a real cleanup that's necessary. I do have a video linked in the description below as well that shows why your computer might be slow and what you can do about it. But you can also look in the task manager and just look at the processor speed, how busy that is, the use of memory, maybe you don't have enough, or the hard drive activity where it may be running at a full out 100%. If you're not able to get anywhere with these suggestions, then you'll have to just hold down the power button on the computer for possibly 10 to 20 seconds depending on the computer, and then it has the power light, you'll notice it go out. Then you can release the power button at that time. It's a good idea to leave it off for 30 seconds before you try turning it back on again. Failing that, you can just simply pull the power cord out of the back. And again, wait 30 seconds while it's unplugged, then plug it back in. But because the power cord was unplugged, you're going to want to wait 10 seconds for the power to start flowing through the board before you can hit the power button. So now that you got your computer up and running again, is it continuously happening? There's a few things you can look at with this. One is to note, when is this consistently happening? Is it consistent to a particular program that you have running? Maybe that program has a conflict with another program, or it's got some damage and it needs to be repaired or reinstalled. The other potential issue is that you have some bad memory. So I have a video on that as well that shows you how you can test your memory. Also, you could have a bad hard drive. And again, I have another video on that linked below that shows you how you can test your hard drive health. There could be some dust buildup. And I show that in my tune-up video that I link below, but I also have this other video that shows you how I found one computer that was so dirty I made a video on it. So it's a good idea to open up the case, and you can pick up a can of compressed air for 10 bucks and just blow the dust out of it. But make sure that you get through all the fans and the grill and the CPU, as well as the fan for the case fan, the CPU fan, the power supply fan. If you have a graphics card, that may also have a fan. Finally, your computer just may need a tune-up, which I mentioned already. I have a video about that linked below as well. So with the tips mentioned in this video, you should be able to not only unfreeze your computer, but be able to determine what may have caused it in the first place and how you can easily prevent it from happening again in the future. If you found this video helpful, please do give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't already, and stay tuned for future videos. Thanks so much. See you in the next one. Bye for now.